وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. My beloved brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He categorized His creation into three stages. The first stage being a person is a tifl, a newborn baby. And then the person moves on from that stage, and then they become a shab, a youth. And then the person leaves that age and they become an old individual. If we look at the Nusus al-Wahiyyin, if we look at the Quran and we look at the Sunnah, we find that the Quran and the Sunnah have given great emphasis and great importance to marhala, to shabab, this stage, the youth. And the scholars, they differ, when does it start and when does it finish? But they agree that there is a marhala called marhalatul shabab. Marhalatul shabab, the shabab, the youths in general, they are quwwatul mujtama', the strength of a society. The prosperity and the success of a society is examined based on their youth. If they have youths who are upright, steadfast, noble, then they have a good future that awaits them. But if their youths are corrupt, criminals, thugs, then this community and this society, they have a dark and dull future that awaits them. وَلِذَلِكَ Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says, الشباب, the youths are like the heart for the body. He says, فَالشَّبَابُ لِلْأُمَّةِ, that the shabab, the youths are for the ummah. كَمَثَلِ الْقَلْبِ لِلْبَدَنِ, like the heart is for the body. إِذَا صَلَحَ صَلَحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ, if the heart is upright and it's good, then the whole body is upright and good. وَإِذَا فَسَدْ, but if the heart becomes corrupt, then the whole body becomes corrupt. And the same applies with the youth. If the youths are upright and they're good, the society and the community are also. And if the youths are becoming corrupt and they lose their steadfastness, so does the community and the society. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told us that the ones who are going to be given shade are people who have seven characteristics. And from them is shabun, a youth, nasha' bi'ibadatillah, who grew up through the obedience of Allah and the worship of Allah. He spent his marhalatul shabab in ibadah, in the remembrance of Allah, following that which Allah commanded him and staying away from that which his Lord prohibited him from. Bukhari and Muslim both narrated the hadith, min hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Rather, Uqbah ibn Amir radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَيَعْجَبُ. Allah is fascinated, he's amazed. مِنَ الشَّابِّ a youth, لَيْسَ لَهُ صَبْوَةً. And he hasn't got sabwa. Ibn Athir, he says in his kitab al-Nihaya fi Gharib al-Hadith that the word as-sabwa means al-maylu ila al-hawa. He doesn't have inclination to desires. Allah is fascinated with a youth who doesn't have inclination towards desires. Why? Because this is not the nature of a shab, a youth. A youth is generally one who is inclined to desires and following his desires. But when the youth chooses not to follow his desires, Allah, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, is fascinated with him. And Imam Ahmad and Abu Ya'la and Tabarani narrated this hadith, and Sheikh Al-Albani rahimahullah, he authenticated it. The youths are afflicted with two types of corruptions. If you observe it, you realize that it doesn't leave one of these two. The first fitna is fitnatu shahawat, desires. And we'll speak about that in details, inshaAllah ta'ala. Fitnatu shahawat, it encompasses major and minor sins. And the second fitna that a youth goes through is al-fitnatu shubuhat, doubts, which encompass al-kufr, disbelief, and al-bid'ah. A lot of the times when the youths are spoken about and how they are going astray and they are deviating, a lot of the people, what comes to their mind is the fitna to shahawat, is what comes to their mind. So if they see the youth dressing in the way he dresses, drinking what he drinks, taking the substance that he takes, not praying his salah, they only think this is the type of fitna that the youth goes through. Rather, there is also another fitna that they go through, which is fitna to ash-shubuhat, doubt. A lot of youths are going to university. They're coming back from university and they're coming home at the right time. They're upstairs, they're reading. Lakin, the problem is, do they believe in Allah's existence? Do they believe in Allah's oneness? That's a question that one needs to ask himself. This is also another problem. So the shabab, when it comes to the fitna to shahawat and the fitna to shubuhat, the ulama, they categorize the shabab into three. And how they are in regards to the inhirafat, the deviation and the astray that they may encounter or come through to. The first of them is a group of youths who realize the dangers that are opening up for them and the harm that wants to come their way. They look at it and they ponder over it, knowing its evil consequences. They fear their Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They fear His punishment subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they regret any shortcomings that they've come with, their faults and their mistakes. They run to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these are the ones who are consistently fighting with their fitna to shahawat and the fitna to shubhat. That's the first type of shabab. The second one are those who feel the danger, who understand its problems, and they know the evil consequences which it has. They want the good. They want to be upright. They want to be steadfast. But their nafs is calling them to the opposite. Shayateen al-insi wal-jinn are calling them to the opposite. This one's yurja lahu al-khayr. Khayr is hoped for him. Wa yukhsha alayhi, and it's also feared for him. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he told us in a hadith Ibn Majah narrated, An-Nasa'i and At-Tirmidhi, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنَ, that the believer, إِذَا أَذْنَبَ, if he does a sin and he comes with shortcomings, كَانَتْ نُكْتَةٌ سَوْدَى, a black dot is placed in his heart. فَإِنْ تَابَ وَنَزَعَ, if he repents, if he comes back to his Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, سُقِلَ قَلْبُهُ, his heart is cleaned. فَإِنْ زَادَ زَادَتْ, but if he goes on into the sin, the black dot is made even more. فَذَٰلِكَ الرَّانِ, then the messenger said, this is the ran, meaning this is the heart becoming fully tainted. Then the Prophet recited the ayah, كَلَّا بَلْ رَانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, that their hearts were darkened due to that which their hands have put forth. The third type are those who have no understanding and comprehension of the dangers of the shahawat and the shubuhat. Every single day, they're indulging in whichever of those they want. Those, yukhsha alayhi, it is feared for him, and ya'tiyahu al-mawtu, that death may come to him, wa huwa ala halihi, whilst he's in that situation. Yaqulu Allahu ta'ala, Allah says in the Quran, وَلَيْسَتِ التَّوْبَةُ لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السَّيِّئَاتِ, that repentance is not for the one who is doing sins and is committing crimes. حَتَّى إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَهُمُ الْمَوْتِ, that when death comes to him, قَالَ, he says, إِنِّي تُبْتُ الْآنَ, now I repent. وَلَلَّذِينَ, and it is also not for, الَّذِينَ يَمُوتُونَ وَهُمْ كُفَّارِ, those who die as disbelievers, repentance is not for them. أُولَٰئِكَ, those that were mentioned, Allah says, أَعْتَدْنَا لَهُمْ, we prepared for them, عَذَابًا أَلِيمًا, a severe punishment. So the youth goes through those two fitnas, fitnatu shahawat and fitnatu shubuhat. And which of those two are most dangerous? It is the shubuhat. The doubts are the greatest of them two. وَلِذَٰلِكَ, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, in a hadith al-Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam, and Sheikh Nasir rahimahullah authenticated, min hadith Anas ibn Malik, inna Allah hajaba at-tawbah an sahibi bid'ah, an sahibi kulli bid'atin, that Allah veiled repentance from the innovator until he comes back from his innovation. And what is the reason to that? لِأَنَّ صَاحِبَهُ, because the one who is doing the innovation, لا يَدْرِي أَنَّهُ مُنْحَرِف, he doesn't know he's a deviated person. He doesn't know he's gone astray. بَلْ يَظُنُّ أَنَّهُ, rather he thinks he is, مِنْ بَحْرِ الصَّالِحَاتِ يَغْتَرِف, rather what he thinks is that he's upon the right path. He's taking from the ocean of the righteous people. That's what he believes. And the one who falls into disbelief, the same. He doesn't believe what he's upon is wrong. What are the causes that bring about deviation? The first of them is Hajrul Qur'an, the boycotting of the Qur'an and abandoning the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he explains to us that the boycotting of the Qur'an, it occurs in five different ways. The first of them is, he said, أَحَدُهَا, the first one is هَجْرُ سَمَاعِهِ وَالْإِصْغَاءِ إِلَيْهِ وَهَجْرِ تِلَاوَتِهِ, the person boycotts listening to the Qur'an, bringing your ear attentively to the Qur'an and reciting the Qur'an. The person hardly reads the Qur'an. The Qur'an is in their house, but it gathers dust. They hardly go towards the Qur'an. They don't read it. And many parents are like that when it comes to the Qur'an. And they want their children to go to the Qur'an classes and memorize the book of Allah, when you yourself haven't read the Qur'an. You don't open the Mus'haf. The second, الثاني هجر العمل به, the second one is the person abandons and he boycotts العمل به, to implement the Quran. والوقوف عند حلاله وحرامه, the person boycotts following that which the Quran made halal and that which the Quran made haram. There's no implementation. They don't implement what the verses are saying to them. They believe, or the way that they are, is as though the Qur'an is talking to a third party that is not talking to them. And even if they do read the Qur'an, they're reading it for somebody else, so they can tell somebody else what they are upon is wrong. هَجْرُ الْعَمَلِ بِهِ وَالْوُقُوفُ عِنْدَ حَلَالِهِ وَحَرَامِ وَإِنْ قَرَأَهُ وَآمَنَ بِهِ. Ibn al-Qayyim says, even if he recites the Qur'an and he believes what's in it, he's also abandoned it, because he hasn't implemented the Qur'an. الثالث, the third one, هَجْرُ تَحْكِيمِهِ وَالتَّحَاكُمِ إِلَيْهِ, the person, he abandons ruling by the book of Allah, and he also abandons seeing the Qur'an as a source of judgment. That when a conflict happens, he doesn't run to the Qur'an and find the answer in the Qur'an. And that also, the Qur'an will not be seen as a source of judgment, but rather people will see things that they wrote and things that they put together to be a source of ruling. So they will say, what do we believe as a culture? What should we do? What do we do here in this particular situation? And so the Quran is never looked into. And the Quran is not seen as a source of hukum and at-tahakum. Fi usul al-din wa furu'ih. It is not made at-tahakum in fundamental issues of the religion, nor is it seen in sub-branches of the religion. The person would go to the Quran after they give up. That's where they would go. Or they would take the statements of men over the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Rabi'u, the fourth. Hajru tadabburihi wa tafahumihi. The person boycotts pondering over the Quran and contemplating over it. Wa ma'rifati ma arada al-mutakallimu bihi. And trying to know the speaker, meaning Allah. What is he trying to say to you? What is he trying to request from you? Not giving importance to it, is boycotting it. Al-Khamisu, the fifth. Hajru al-istishfa'i. The person boycotts taking the Quran as a source of cure. وَالتَّدَاوِي بِهِ فِي جَمِيعِ أَمْرَاضِ الْقُلُوبِ. With all of the illnesses there are, whether it be the illnesses of the heart or the illnesses of the body, the person doesn't see the Quran. So they first try the doctor, they first try the medication. And once the doctor says that your illness is a chronic illness, there's nothing that can be done for you, then and only then does the person say, where is the mushaf? Where are the mashayikh, the ulama? Can they read Quran on me? The Quran is seen as the last source. And then Ibn al-Qayyim says, rahimahullah, wa kullu hada. And all of those five that were mentioned in this verse, mentioned from the boycotting of the Quran, wa kullu hada dakhilun fi shakwa rasulillah. All of those fall under the complaint of the Prophet of Allah when he complained to Allah by saying, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ. The messenger said, my Lord Allah, إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا. My people have taken this Qur'an مَهْجُورًا. They boycotted this Qur'an and they abandoned it. These 5 points, Ibn al-Qayyim says, it encompasses it. But what is even worse, brothers? وَتَعْظُمُ الْمُصِيبَةِ وَتَشْتَدُّ الْكُرْبَةِ. The calamity becomes great and the pain even increases more when the people do what? In istubdila bihi ghayruh. When other than the Quran is placed in its place. When people start to listen to what they nowadays call anashid islamiyah. The person won't listen to the Quran. The person will not look at the Quran. They will abandon the Quran and they will replace it with that which they call anashid islamiyah. They will replace it with that. Or they will replace it with music. And they would listen to it. Wallahi, the musibah becomes more. And then you understand why the pain is there. As-sababu thani, the second reason why the ummah, the youths, are deviating and going astray is al-bu'du an sunnati al-habib al-mustafa. That the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his sunnah, we've boycotted it. We've turned our backs on it. And we've distanced ourselves from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَىٰ وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّىٰ وَنُسْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ, anyone who goes against the Prophet's path, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَىٰ, after it becomes clear to him, the correct path becomes clear to them, and the truth has been told to them, and they go against the path of the believers, Allah says, نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّىٰ. You will be left to the path that you've chosen. And then Allah says, وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ. And their hellfire will be made your final abode. وَسَاءَتْ مَسِيرًا. And what an evil place it will be. The person will stay there because they turned away from the Prophet's path and they turned away from the path of the believers. Allah says in another ayah, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ. Let them be cautious. Those who are opposing the path and the way of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what's going to happen to them? أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً. فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً. أَنْ يُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةً. A calamity may come their way. أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. Or that they may endure a severe punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah, he said that the fitna here in the verse means a shirku. Why is it shirk? Because the person has chosen a path other than the path of the Prophet. And so they made that equal to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Messenger told us sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in a hadith al-Imam Ahmad narrated in his Musnad and Ibn Majah in his Sunan, that the Prophet said, تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى مِثْلِ الْبَيْضَاءِ, I have left you upon a white, clear path. لَيْلُهَا كَالنَّهَارِهَا, its night is like day. لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا بَعْدِ إِلَّا هَالِكِ, the only person who will be destroyed after me is the one who takes other than that path. The one who deviates from that path. The path which is what? He is sunnah alayhi salatu wasalam. He also said in another hadith that al-Imam Hakim narrated in his Mustadrak, إِنِّي قَدْ تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَن تَضِلُّ أَبَدًا. The Messenger said, I have left that which if you were to hold on to, you'll never be misguided. Kitab Allah, the book of Allah, wa sunnata nabiyyihi, and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu ma tasma'un wa astaghfiru Allah li wa lakum wa li sa'iri al-muslimin min kulli dhanb fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. السبب الثالث, the third reason why the shabab and the youths they go astray is فهم نصوص الكتاب والسنة بغير فهم سلف الأمة. Understanding the Quran and the Sunnah in other than the understanding of the pious predecessors, and in a way in which the companions did not understand it. The Messenger told us in a hadith that Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunan, and al-Tirmidhi in his Jami', and al-Imam ibn Majah in his Sunan, that the Prophet said in hadith Irbad ibn Sariyah, وَإِنَّهُ مَنْ يَعِشْ مِنْكُمْ, whoever from amongst you lives, فَسَيَرَ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا, he's going to see a lot of disputes. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّتِي, upon you is my sunnah. وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِيِّينَ, the Prophet then said, the sunnah of my rightly guided khulafa, Abi Bakr and Umar and Uthman and Ali, their path. So look what the Prophet said here, upon you is my path and the path of my rightly guided khulafa, meaning Abu Bakr, Umar and Uthman. Addu alayha bin nawajid, hold on to that with your molar teeth. Wa iyyakum, and stay away from the paths other than that. This hadith told us that the path in which we need to take is not the path of the Prophet alone sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that it should be with the path of the companions and how they understood it. A lot of the youths who are today, we're seeing, who either go towards the fitna tool, ash-shubuhat, doubt enter them, where they become radicalized in their belief. You find that they read the Quran and the Sunnah in an understanding that the Sahabas and the students of the companions didn't understand it. And this is very vital. How do you understand the Quran? And how do you understand the Sunnah? The inhiraf and the deviation comes when you understand it on an understanding which they never understood it. Abu Dawood narrated in his Sunnah, and I'm going to conclude with this, and that Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiyallahu ta'ala anhu qala li julasaihi yawma. Mu'adh one day said to those who were sitting with him one day, and Abu Dawood narrated this in his Sunan, that Mu'adh said, inna min wara'ikum fitana, there's going to come trials and tribulations, yakthuru fiha al-malu, wealth is going to become a lot, the people are going to be very rich, وَيُفْتَحُ فِيهَا الْقُرْآنِ, and the Qur'an will be open for everybody. Every single body would memorize the Qur'an. حَتَّى يَأْخُذَهُ الْمُؤْمِنُ وَالْمُنَافِقُ وَالرَّجُلُ وَالْمَرْأَةُ وَالصَّغِيرُ وَالْكَبِيرُ وَالْعَبْدُ وَالْحُرُّ, everyone would take the Quran. The mu'min would memorize the Quran. Even the hypocrite would memorize the Quran. The man would memorize the Quran. The woman would memorize the Quran. The child will memorize the Quran. The elders will memorize the Quran. Wal abdu, the slave, will memorize the Quran. Wal hurru, the free individual, will memorize the Quran. Fayushiku qailun, then a person will then say, an yaqula ma lin nasi la yattabi'uni, why is it that the people are not following me? Why am I not getting followers? Waqad qara'tu al-Qur'ana, when I have read the Quran from the beginning to the end, meaning I've memorized it. Ma hum bimuttabi'iyya, these people are not going to follow me. Hatta abtadi'a, until I innovate something for them. I have to bring something that will attract them. Hatta abtadi'a lahum ghayra, until I innovate for them something other than the Quran. Fa'iyyakum, Mu'adh said, stay away. Wa mabtudi'a, and that which has been innovated. Fa'inna mabtudi'a dalalatun, for verily that which will be innovated that day will be misguidance. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wansurna 'ala al-qawm al-kafirin. Allahumma ighfir lana hazlana wa jiddana wa khata'ana wa 'amdana wa kullu dhalika 'indana ya rabbal 'alamin. Allahumma la taj'al ad-dunya akbara hammina wa la mablagha 'ilmina wa la tusallit 'alaina bidhunubina man la yakhafuka fina wa la yarhamuna. Rabbi ati nufusana taqwaha وزكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.